welcome back. So I've got a whole day to just film a load of videos, so I'm gonna do that. So I'm gonna do that for y'all. I look dead right now. Like, I'm just looking at myself in the viewfinder thinking, I look pasty as fuck. I'm gonna start off with this liquid highlighter. No idea what it's gonna be like. It is from Makeup Revolution Unicorn Reflex, it says. Sure how I feel about that. Not really sure. It feels oily and it's obviously a gimmick for all the other highlighting drops and whatnot. I look purple, but obviously that is because of the whole unicorn effect. We'll see how it sits with my makeup, because I look a little bit glittery right now. So foundation, I'm going to use, feels a bit weird on my face, that does. I bet it's the glitter. Does it even say liquid highlighter, it says. That don't feel right on my face. That don't feel right. Am I reacting to this? It stings a bit. We'll see what happens. We'll see. MAC Studio Fix foundation. This is in NC30, which is going to be way too dark for me right now, but we're going to go darker because I like to be darker. So yeah, let's whack that on with Real Techniques sponge. Yeah, that'll tan me up a bit. Oh, I feel so much better already, I do. Look at the colour that it has brought back to me. Mate. Oh, so much better. Oh my God, I'm not a fan of this unicorn. And then I'm gonna go in with some concealer. I'm just gonna try out some new bits. So this is BH Studio Pro Total Coverage Concealer in 105. So this is the lid it has. Might work, and it's very yellow tone, which is good. A lot comes out. That's definitely a good colour. It looks really good so far, but obviously the main part is the under eye, so let's see how that goes. That is super full coverage. So there is that on. I feel, and for me, this is a statement for me to say this, I feel caked on. And I cake it on. But I mean, I feel caked on, proper. That looks so full coverage, I feel like I need to put like quite a bit of bronzer on to like, I feel one tone right now, which I do look it. So I need to sort that out. But it is full coverage, but obviously because of the applicator, loads comes out at once. So I am going to powder my under eye, which obviously means more powder, more powder, more coverage. It's not what I want right now, but I have no choice. So using NYX HD powder in Banana, my favorite, underneath my under eye. Honestly, that is my favorite banana powder to use. It's affordable. I use it on clients, I use it on myself. It's just unreal. And there is no flashback. There can be if you whack it on, but make sure you proper blend it out. Like, keep going over it, brush it right in, buff it in, and you'll be fine. Go into the Anastasia Beverly Hills palette and take this Jessup brush. It's off eBay, don't ask me where to find it, because I don't know. Okay, I'm starting to come back to life. Slowly but surely. Next is MAC Give Me Sun Bronzer, another favourite of mine. And now I can actually make it look like I'm tanned, even though I haven't hit a sunbed or been in the sun for God knows how long. But we'll just tan this body and make out it's real. So now I need to go into some blush, my favourite one, I'm still using it at the moment, California Dreaming, which smells absolutely amazing. And then I'm gonna go, don't even with this highlight. Don't even, you need to get ready to buy this ASAP. It's not even expensive. They're getting bigger. They're the next thing. Dole Beauty, you might have heard of the lashes, they have highlight as well. It's the highlight that I'm using today. I've already smashed it, and then put it all back together, smashed it again, and it's on its last legs now. But yeah, just wait for it. Wait for it. Where's my brush at? This is, it just says number one on it. I don't even know if I can put this on right now. I feel like I should put it on the end. Shall I? You know what? You can wait. Now, it's time for these hot pink eyes. Hot pink. I am going to cover my entire eyelid with concealer as usual for a base for all the eyeshadows to sit on. It makes the eyeshadow stand out more, makes them pop more, more bold. You get the gist. So, I don't think you're ready for this hot pink. The one thing I can't stand when you haven't been filming for ages is when you come back and the amount of times you have to go, hey, welcome back. Hey, welcome back to my, no, okay. Hey, welcome back to my channel, make sure you subscribe. No. And you have to keep repeating yourself constantly. Right, this palette. I used this palette for my Halloween look, which was blue, a lot of blue, and I'm gonna film that look as well. It's basically the same look, but in pink I'm doing, using the same eyeshadow technique, but using the pinks in here. So I'm gonna go straight into Kogi, which is this one. Nah, you ain't ready for this pink, trust me. Doing a halo effect, so you wanna do the outside, the inside, and the crease, so you're leaving just the center of the eye free, like a spotlight, and this is gonna go underneath as well. A lot of pink, it is very, I say simple, but it's more simple for me. It should be for you. There's only two to three main colours, really. So yeah. So, going to the pink. I'm then going to go into this Iconic London brush. Because it's super soft hairs, it blurs out the edges really easily. I'm going to take a smaller brush. This one is a Zoeva 227. So I'm going to repeat that, but underneath, so it's going to be really bright pink smoky underneath. And I'm going to connect them two together. And the same again, I'm just going to soften it with the Iconic brush. So at the moment, that looks quite scary, very in your face. So now you need to put more tones in to make it a look. You couldn't just be able to put some lashes on and go up like this. So I'm now going to go into the Modern Essence palette and take Love Letter, which is this one here. And go in the crease, doing both sides, just packing more product on to create more depth in the eyeshadow. And I'm gonna put it underneath, closer to the lash line. So you see, just by adding one other colour, how much difference it can make to the eye look already. So you need to put more colours on, more depth. My arm feels like it's literally going to fall off. So the next part is to do the halo part on the eye. And for that, I'm going to be using some Peaches and Cream pigments. I'm going to use Kitten, which is like a light pink. Fantasy, which is like a pink reflect. So it looks white, but it comes out with pink reflex, like I just said. I need to create the halo first, so I need my concealer and a flat brush again to do that. So I need to create the halo in the middle by cutting the crease in the middle, so I'm just gonna show you how to do it. So the concealer's already on there. I pat down and pull the brush down to create the cut crease, and then I sharpen the line by going back and forth at the top, literally drawing the line with the brush. So then you need to blend out the edges. So I'm going to get a brush. What one am I going to get? Just any brush. So the edges need to be blended out, otherwise you're going to get a sharp line where the concealer is. So you need to blend it out so that it ends up being smooth and that the concealer doesn't stand out dramatically on your eyes. So only the edges I blend out. So each side, do not touch the top because you want that sharp line there. And then with the same brush, obviously take the concealer off. I'm going to go in with the pigments and you literally just pat them on. that's literally just on the edge. I'm blending it out. Like so. And then it's time for Fantasy, which is gonna be very glittering. So pretty, so, so pretty. I'm now gonna put on some black liner in my waterline and liquid liner on top, just a simple line. Can you see I need more bronzer? I look washed out again. For mascara, I'm going to be using Charlotte Tilbury Full Fat Lashes. So you can see a bit of a mistake on my eye. It kind of makes me look a bit punk now, having that there. Like I've got a little teardrop or something. Do not touch it. Leave it to dry. Do not touch it whilst it's wet. I will show you how to fix that situation. So lashes that I want to put on, I'm not actually sure which ones. I've got a bunch from Ardell. God, what ones do I want? Okay, so I'm going to go for these ones. Hopefully they will stand out inner. And then after that, this will be dry that I can show you how to get rid of it. Okay, so I'm back with my lips on. Eyes are all done. I now need to get rid of that thing on my face. So I'm going to get a spoolie and I'm literally going to scratch it off. And then I'm going to get a brush, rub over it. Voila. Okay. Gone. It just lifts up. Just that's all you've got to do. Don't even worry about it. You can thank me later. I'm going to put a bit more mascara on these lashes because they're not dramatic enough for me. Just going to wax some more on. And now, if I go back to what I was saying about the concealer, it doesn't look as caked on now that I've got other colours on, but and it doesn't feel it either. And it doesn't look it as much anymore, but it did feel like it at the beginning. Okay, MAC Nylon eyeshadow. That's going to go in my inner corner. And brow bone. I'm going to do my hair. Voila! So there's obviously one last step to do. So this is Dull Beauty Highlight in Shine Bright. And this is BH Cosmetics Brush in 1. One go! That's one go! I just can't with this. I can't. And then I'm going to do the other side. Now I've also started doing my chin, which I didn't used to do. This is what I mean, I feel like I literally have not been here forever. So let's get that chin going. That tip of the nose. And down the bridge. This is about to change the world. This is going to change the world, it really is. So then you want, obviously, Urban Decay All Night Setting Spray to set my life up. So now that I'm drenched, I'm going to come back in a second when I'm actually dry. That's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and it helped you out. It's a lot more easier than what it looks. And obviously, it's fun as well, which I love doing bright, fun looks. Thumbs up, but make sure you subscribe. Subscribe now, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.